Hi, my name is Howard. I'm an international student from Taiwan. Maybe you don't know where Taiwan is. Taiwan is the tropical island in Asia. So since I'm from the warm place, I got so many opportunities to see different kinds of bugs. You can see the ants march on the tree and thousands of cicada sing around people. It was so interesting. And maybe this is the reason why I love bugs. But I also have some bad memory about bugs. Just a few years ago, before I retired from the military, I had peers pick up a grasshopper from somewhere and put it into the fish tank. They want to see the fish having the grasshopper. However, the grasshopper was too big. It was struggling in the water and freaked out all the fish. There were none of them getting bites even if it died. Can you imagine the ugly huge creature just lying down at the bottom of the fish tank? Well, it was a nightmare. Because it just displayed there for several days and nobody wanna clean it. Hey Lexi, can you tell me what bugs you are most afraid of?
Cockroach, duh.
But do you know why Lexi had them? Well, because of jealousy, she cannot fly. Well, I think sometimes we should be jealous of them because their ability is totally beyond human's imagination. And my favorite example is spider. The web spider mech is stronger than steels and most of material in the world. So Spider-Man is not just a kidding. From some perspective, it's so true. There's the thing they're same as human is they perform homosexual behavior. People with homophobia say homosexual is our nature because they don't have offspring and it will make creature extinct. Is that fair enough? Well, not really. In real conditions, you can see homosexual activity in most of the animals. And remember, homosexual is not just a happy yesterday. It has a very long history. So if it never disappeared, it must have some significant meaning. In fact, it can make species flourish rather than extinct. Sounds very tricky, right? Well, before we know that, let me tell you a story. It's about a giraffe. Once upon a time, there were three giraffes living in Africa. Hoa, Nexi, and Migre. They all looked the same. However, Hoa's neck was longer than Lexi and Migre by 3 centimeters. Their life was happy. Besides eating, they didn't do anything. But one day, they have found out that all leaves that grow on the long tree had been eaten. Only leaves on the upper parts left. Lexi and Migre were unable to reach the higher leaves, so they starved and died. Hoa was so happy, because there were no others who would steal his food. Next year, Hoa got 3 offspring. Howard, Dana, and Yizi. This time, their necks had same length. But Howard's legs were longer than Dana and Yizi by 3 centimeters. So when predator chased them, Howard had more chances to escape from it. Nonetheless, Dana and Yizi became the predator's dinner. The story is the famous theory called natural selection from Charles Darwin, which is the individual who has positive genetic mutation will have a higher survival rate, and they will also get more opportunity to reproduce their offspring, which has the similar feature as them. And the 3 centimeter we just mentioned is the positive genetic mutation, same as gay behavior. But why gay need to survive by gay behavior? Imagine there were 2 bugs, Mr. Howard and Mr. Lexi. Mr. Lexi is moral, he only mates with one single other. Also, it took a long time to identify his potential mate if it was female before having sex. Howard was totally different, without identification. He could have sex with any genders. In this case, Howard had more efficiency. He got more opportunities to reproduce his offspring. Lexi was accurate, but he wasted too much time. Even he was right. And the pity is, he was unable to spread his moral gene to the next generation. And that's the reason why more than 80% of bugs perform homosexual behavior. How about human? Human is an other story, but the foundation is the same. Based on the book On Human Nature, the author biologist E.O Wilson gave the explanation for homosexual phenomena. He believed homosexual behavior is for social division lover. He pointed out homosexual people have a higher performance rate in intelligence tests than heterosexual people. They don't have offspring, so in the past, they might serve as having higher social status, like a seer, shaman, or artist. This halo can provide the better survival rate for their nephew, niece, or sibling, and they use that way to continue their gene, or potential homosexual gene. In a nutshell, although gay cannot have offspring, but they can still do other meaningful contribution for our society, eventually. If this is true, and homosexual behavior is just one component of God's plan, isn't it? So there's nothing on nature. If it is, you will never see it develop so well. Thanks for watching this video. If you want to get further information, the link, connection, and reference is over there. I hope this video can give you a different perspective on gay. And thanks for my teacher, Mr. Pico, gave me such a great opportunity to do the research. I hope you enjoy it. My name's Howard, and see you next time. Bye!